Hi guys and welcome! Before we start with this video, I want to give a huge thank you to all of my subscribers. We have finally passed 10,000 subscribers. I think that I will do some kind of subscriber special soon, where I just take a look at my old videos and how hilarious they were. But today, obviously, something new has arrived here. This is the Apple HomePod. It has just arrived from eBay because obviously it's not available in Germany. Some of you know that I live in Berlin. But I got one from eBay. That one guy bought it in the UK and he said, well, okay, you can have it. I think I paid 400 euros. This is actually the price which it probably will be released in Europe as well, so it's actually quite fair. And I just couldn't wait, as really there wasn't a good sound check on YouTube. Maybe some of you know my channel, maybe some of you are also new. On this channel, I check speakers on their pure sound quality. I wear high quality binaural microphones, which require obviously headphones to sound good. I use the DPA 4060 microphones, so you can get a really realistic sound impression of how the speaker really sounds, even over YouTube. Yes, that is possible. And yeah, overall on YouTube you can find some sound checks, but there was one with a really good microphone. I was like, okay, it sounds actually half decent, sounds better than all of the other smart speakers. Then I watched another video, which also was recorded with a good microphone, and suddenly it sounded worse than a Bose sounding mini. So you cannot really get a good impression on YouTube. Everyone says something else. Some say it's lacking treble, some say it has too much treble, but the overall feedback from the customers was positive. Everyone was just hating on Siri, because Siri can obviously do nothing. But sound-wise, everyone really said that it sounds nice and that it sounds very convincing. And even Tim Cook said that the quality will blow people away. So today we're going to check this out. So now, let's get it open. Test this kind of Apple typical pull tab. And obviously the presentation, okay, it already, wait, lifts itself, is really nice as usual for Apple. And I think I got the white unit, although I have ordered a space gray one, but from the packaging you can't really tell. So now we have the moment of truth. The entire, I don't know, Bluetooth speaker YouTubers have been excited. And here it is. As you can see, it's the white version. So the guy sent me the wrong one. I think he had six or so, two black ones and four white ones. Well, sadly I got a white one, but here it is. And it looks, actually it's not as small as everyone says. Everyone says it's much smaller than expected. But it's pretty nice. Let's take it out. That's, yeah, smells like rubber. Typical for Apple. And in here we just get some manuals designed by Apple in California, obviously made in China. You get some Apple stickers and a manual. But of course, the pairing process should be pretty easy thanks to the Apple W1 chip inside. So yeah, pretty much you just hold your iPhone next to it. And this is already the first problem. This thing has no Bluetooth built in. You can only pair it with an iPhone or an iPad, and you need Apple Music in order to play music over this thing. Of course, you can also use AirPlay and then play music via Spotify, but like this, you won't get any smart functions. And I think that this is simply dumb by Apple. They could have simply, I don't know, made it a little bit more open to other sources, as this is very, very limited to the Apple ecosystem. Thankfully, I'm a, I don't know, total, how do you say this, Apple sheep or something. And this is why it's obviously a speaker which I could use, but of course it's about the sound. And now let's maybe remove the foil. So yeah, the packaging is really, really nice, better than with any other speaker. Let's also take a look at the cord here. Yeah, it's a braided one, so also high quality, but this is of course what you would expect for the price tag. Let's remove this. As you can see, it's a UK plug, so it's a little bit bigger than the ones in Germany, but of course I have an adapter here, so you can use them in my country, or I can use it in my country as well. Otherwise I would have been screwed, because this is obviously the wrong plug. Let's remove this foil as well. Foils everywhere. And then, yeah, this is the speaker. So we have the cord, which actually is removable. Some people found this out. If you pull on it really hard, you can get it off. Yeah, I was also planning on doing a disassembly video on it, but after having seen the videos from I think What's Inside and I Fix It, yeah, I know that you have to destroy it in order to get it open, which is so typical for Apple. And this is the second issue next to Siri's lacking intelligence. It also is very expensive to repair, so you cannot get it open. You would, I think, you need to use some kind of saw or something to, I don't know, cut it open and then the speaker will break anyways. But of course, Apple sealed it so nicely so that you have to go into the Apple Store and pay 80% of the resale price in order to get, one new speaker inside if something breaks or so. So this is again where I think, Apple, why do you have to do this? I know how cheap it is to make such a speaker and you pay 80% of the resale price just to get one exchanged part. This is simply what annoys me a little bit. But of course, today we are here for the sound. I won't focus on any smart features as I simply know what Siri can do. It's not that much. You know, I am personally an Amazon Echo user. I can turn on my lights and everything, control some stuff. She can tell jokes or something, while Siri really is lacking all features compared to Amazon. But this again is not what I want to talk about today, as you can simply watch any other review. Most other YouTubers just go ahead and read specs from the website, say, yeah, we have a horn-loaded tweeter and one big subwoofer. Well, what's this? I mean, I need a sound check with good microphones in order to really understand if the claims by Apple are true. Talking about the speakers, it has a 7 tweeter array at the bottom to deliver some kind of 360-degree sound. And after having seen the first disassembly video, I can also tell you that those are not horn-loaded tweeters. They just are some cheap, tweeters, yes, tweeters, but they don't have a horn in front of them. They rather have some kind of small waveguide, so I wouldn't quite count this as a horn speaker. Maybe you know the big ones, I don't know from which company, JBL uses them quite often. Those are bigger than the entire speaker, while a waveguide is really tiny, so this is what would fit in there. Still, of course, it's about the sound. And as a last speaker, you have a big woofer on top. I think it's about 4 inches and they are claiming 2.5 centimeters of max excursion, which is insane for such a small woofer. I mean, the one of the Phantom, you know how much air this thing moves, has about 1.5 centimeters of peak excursion, and this thing should have 1 centimeter more excursion, which would be insane. I saw the video by What's Inside, they did a bass test, and indeed it has a pretty big rubber ceiling and moves quite a bit of air. But now let's grab this cable here and plug it in. Hopefully everything works and I've bought the right adapter. Yes, so you can see, looks pretty funny. Yeah, obviously there will be a Europe version soon. I'm not sure when it will be released, but I just couldn't wait, so I went on eBay and ordered it. And now I want to plug it in, and then we will simply quickly pair it up with my iPhone, which should work in a few seconds, thanks to the W1 chip. So as you can see, you get this kind of light on top, which in my opinion looks really, really nice. Sadly, again, I couldn't get the black version, although I've requested it, because I think that in this case, this kind of LED on top looks even nicer, but the white one will do it for now. And now, we can already see it, just appeared, HomePod konfigurieren, so this is obviously in German. So as you can see, there was an error, but this is because I'm in flight mode, so I will try it again in a second, and we will see us in the sound check. So as always, please grab your headphones, as this is a high quality binaural microphone recording and they require headphones to sound good. As always, I will be wearing my headcam to give you some kind of live impression of the sound check, and then I will simply start comparing it to some other speakers. And again, overall I can say so far I really like it. I like the looks of it. It feels very heavy, so I think it's 2.5 kilograms. You can see from the front it's not that much bigger than a phone. A little bit taller. And now I will simply right away switch to the sound check. So today we have 3 contenders. The first one, which is the FIFA Helsinki, it pretty much resembles, the most hi-fi speaker in this class. It has the best resolution and best mid-range performance in this class. Then we have the Harman Kardon Go Play, which is the standard for dynamic sound, bass performance in this class. So it has a lot of power. Mid-range and treble is average, but the bass and the dynamics are really nice with the Harman Kardon. And then in the end, we are going to compare it against a very similar speaker, which is the B&O S3. It basically is as big as the HomePod, also sounds pretty similar, but just doesn't have any smart functions. Let's grab the FIFA Helsinki here, and let's turn it on. Maybe some of my viewers, maybe some of you are also new, know the FIFA Helsinki. It's a pretty hi-fi sounding speaker, it has an almost linear frequency response, and it sounds really natural. It's a very nice reference in this class. And again, it's the reference for mid-range and treble here, and the Go Play will be the reference for bass. So now, let's see. Yes, we are connected, and I will start with a track by Superfreesia. Take some time. Perhaps you could hear the FIFA had a little bit more sparkle, also mid-range was a bit clearer, but the Apple HomePod actually kept up nicely. You could hear it didn't have any funky treble boost at the presence region like UE or Bose does all the time, but it actually sounds pretty neutral, just not as refined as the FIFA. But of course, this is still fine, as the FIFA resembles the best in this class, and the HomePod isn't that far off, which is really impressive. Now let's try one more classical track to see how big the difference really is. Yeah, you can see sometimes it still takes some time. Let's try out this track. So again, you can hear the FIFA has slightly more resolution, a bit nicer mid-range. Still, the difference is there, but I'm just shocked that the Apple HomePod sounds this, let's say, hi-fi. I expected hollow mids, some weird, harsh treble due to the tweeter placement. But it seems like Apple really has put in some nice work. Obviously, Apple is a huge company. They have, I think, $25 billion in cash, so they can definitely afford to buy all the three companies I just named and simply copy their products. So that's no issue for them. I know that Apple can build good speakers, but still, I thought maybe they didn't give a damn about the sound and just wanted to release it. But they actually put some effort into it. But let's try one more track, and then we will check out the next speaker. Sometimes it really takes a while. Yeah, the FIFA still has a little bit more sparkle. It still sounds more linear than the HomePod, but I also think that this wasn't the goal of Apple. They pretty much wanted a speaker which sounds good overall, also for people who like modern sound, And this is definitely what they have achieved here. Treble and mid-range doesn't sound weird or off. It's just not as clear and as refined as the one of the FIFA, but that's totally fine. I mean, there's no heavy treble boost in the presence region, no hollow mids. It just sounds neutral and actually pretty good. So I was pretty impressed by this. Also, price-wise, they are pretty comparable. The FIFA went for $400. I think it has dropped to $330, so they are pretty similar. And sound-wise, I can tell you, they are pretty much on one level. The FIFA maybe is better for acoustic music as it still offers more resolution, more mid-range performance. It's simply a little bit more linear and clearer. But when it comes to bass performance, I personally would definitely prefer the Apple HomePod as it obviously offers more punch, more kick, more dynamic sound. So it's about you which one you like more. I hope you already made your decision here. But now let's check out the next speaker, the Harman Kardon Go Play here. As you can see, it's quite a bit bigger, but also a little bit cheaper. It goes for about, I think, $250 to $300. So it's about $50 or even more less expensive than the HomePod. Still, I think that sound-wise, they are pretty comparable. Let's try another track, maybe this one. So you could hear it sounded pretty convincing even here. Yeah, the Harman Kardon really is the reference for dynamic sound, especially for modern music in this class. It has 2 4-inch drivers, I think, and 2 5 or also 4-inch passive radiators. So one passive radiator at the front, one at the back, and 2 main drivers on the left and the right. So it definitely is equipped with way more powerful drivers than the HomePod, but the HomePod still manages to appear really nice. It has, I think, almost the same bass kick. Of course, on higher volumes, the Go Play will play louder. You can see it's also bigger, but the Go Play isn't that much louder. It's a little bit louder, so maybe better for a party, but the difference isn't huge, and both also sound pretty nice on max volume, although I would give the edge for to the HomePod here, as it still keeps a bit more bass, sounds a little bit less compressed than the Harman Kardon Go Play on max volume, but again, on the other hand, is a little bit softer. Let's check out one more track here by Maroon 5. You gotta tell me if you love me or not, love me or not, love me or not. I'm wishing for you, am I lucky or not, lucky or not, lucky or not? Let's try out one more track here, maybe this one. And if you ask why I don't. Oh. also where you have the baselines already over, but you could again hear the HomePod could keep up, although if you just want a speaker for music listening and you say, okay, I listen to a lot of modern music, not so much acoustic, I mean, both still sound okay. With acoustic music, maybe the HomePod even better. But if you say, okay, I'm an average music listener, but I also like modern music quite a bit, then the Harman Kardon pretty much is the better choice there. It can play again a little bit louder on high volumes. It keeps a little bit more bass. Just on max volume, I would maybe prefer the HomePod. And you could still hear it sounds a bit more dynamic. You know, of course, it has more stereo because it's just bigger, but the bass reached a little bit lower or deeper than the HomePod. Also sounded a bit more kicking, a bit more dynamic. So the Go Play remains the king for dynamics and bass in this class. But still, the HomePod could keep up nicely. I didn't expect this, especially given its small size. So maybe let's check out this track. Also has some heavy bass kicks from Sopason again. Let's check out a jazz track now, or some kind of acoustic track. So again, with the Harman Kardon, you get the advantage of having real stereo sound. Of course, the Harman Kardon has two tweeters, two full range drivers, so the tracks or the sounds are definitely coming from the left and the right. While with the HomePod, it's all coming from one spot. I think that this kind of fake stereo processing from Apple just didn't work. I will try a track in a second where we can really hear that this didn't quite work out as they are marketing. But still, I would say against the FIFA, the HomePod still has quite a big difference when it comes to mid-range and treble. It only sounded better in the bass, so it sounded more powerful than the FIFA Helsinki. But in mid-range and treble, I would still definitely pick the FIFA for acoustic music. With the Harman Kardon, it's another story. Bass-wise, I would slightly prefer the Harman Kardon still, as it sounds more kicking, of course, just due to physical advantages. It's bigger, it has more drivers, more power. In the mid-range and treble section, I would think that both are pretty similar. Maybe the mids are slightly nicer, slightly more direct on the HomePod. But of course, the Harman Kardon has nicer stereo. So for acoustic music, I would say that both of them sound equally good. Maybe the HomePod is slightly better, but I think it's a head-to-head race. And again, bass-wise, the Harman Kardon slightly wins. So now let's check out this one track by Pink Floyd here to check if it really has stereo. You can hear everything comes from one spot. And this is how it needs to sound. So yeah, you can clearly hear everything's coming from the left and right with the Go Play, while everything just comes from one spot with the HomePod again. the HomePod now. Yeah, maybe sounds slightly more spacious with more depth, just because you have tweeters at the back as well. But I would say for, I don't know, real stereo imaging, the GoPlay obviously wins, again, due to physical advantages. It's simply the broader speaker, and this is why it can deliver more stereo. But now I would say that we will try out the BNOS3. I will set it up as it's powered from mains as well, and then we will do the last comparison. So as you can see, I set up both of them next to each other, and I think that the B&O is the real competitor. You can see it's only slightly bigger than the HomePod, while the GoPlay was quite a bit bigger than the HomePod, and both of them also have a pretty similar sound tuning. I mean, the S3, maybe you know it, has a huge treble boost, so it's pretty much for people who are slightly deaf, which cannot hear treble that good anymore. It has a huge treble boost, way too harsh for some people. But otherwise, when it comes to mid-range and bass performance, I think that both are pretty similar. Both of them sound pretty punchy, pretty full-bodied, and have a rather dynamic tuning, rather than a hi-fi sound like 3 for Helsinki. And I also think that the comparison is very fair. As you can see, both of them don't have a battery, both of them are almost the same size and weight, and of course both of them also have the almost same drivers. Like the S3 has a 4-inch bass driver, the HomePod has a 4-inch bass driver, while with the Harman Kardon, the Harman Kardon had 4-inch bass drivers, and that's obviously unfair. But now let's start with a comparison with another modern track and the HomePod playing first. Always takes ages for it to switch. Yeah, sorry for the ending. The HomePod didn't connect anymore. So I think there definitely needs a software update for the connection. I mean, if they don't offer Bluetooth, at least get the Wi-Fi properly working. But again, sound-wise, you could hear both of them were pretty similar, although I would even say that the HomePod sounds more neutral. I mean, it has a flatter mid-range and treble response, rather close to a GoPlay, not close to the FIFA. The FIFA still sounded quite a bit more refined. But still, the overall attempt of treble and mid-range is rather similar to the GoPlay or the FIFA than to the S3, as the S3 has a huge treble boost. You could hear it sounds very, very, how do you say this, not harsh, but rather ear-ringing, if you can say it like this. And the HomePod sounded more neutral. Bass-wise, I would say both of them sound really nice. They both had nice bass kick, and I think that this track will underline this even more. Again, the HomePod starting first. Both of them sound very similar in the bass kick. Let's try out this track. So again, you could hear both of them sounded quite similar. The bass kick on the S3 maybe was a little bit more precise, a bit more dense than on the HomePod, as the HomePod sometimes tends to sound slightly, how to say this, out of control, like it's moving a little bit too much air and cannot take it anymore, while the S3 always sounds very punchy and dense. So maybe the S3 is better in this case, but still, I would say bass-wise, both of them have the same amount of power. Both of them also have, similar size drivers built in, so that's obviously logical. Mid-range and treble maybe was nice on the HomePod, as I really don't like this treble boost of the S3. The S3 sounds very harsh, sometimes when you have some electronic music where you already have boosted treble, and then the S3 boosts the treble even more, it becomes way too harsh for the ear. I would rather put some kind of tissue between the driver and the grill, then the treble gets a little bit less. While the HomePod, on the other hand, sounds more neutral in the mid-range and treble, while still offering the same amount of detail. So maybe this is the one you like more. Now let's try one of the last tracks. You can hear again a lot of treble. It might sound clear to some of you, but it's a little bit too much. Now let's maybe check out an acoustic track by Leonard Cohen. I tend to use it quite often as I really like it, and then I think that we should be done.
And where is my gypsy wife tonight? Where is my gypsy wife tonight?
Let's try the very last track.
Fresh young wife, dare not show her face. New tracks in the snow, the buck and the doe. My only companions are 40 below. There was an old bridge you used to live in this house. Traveling hammock, both north and south. Old witch living.
So yeah, now we are done with this comparison. I think it got quite a bit too long, so I really don't want to make it any longer, but I just quickly want to sum this up and, I don't know, give you my overall feedback on the speaker. So yeah, giving a small sound verdict, I think that this thing definitely is a really good sounding speaker. You could hear, I really like that it has this kind of 360 degree speaker sound. It pretty much sounds good from any angle, no matter where you place it. And what I also really like is that it not only sounds much better than I expected it to sound like a bigger UE Wonderboom, but it really is one of the best in this class. And again, what I really also like is that it sounds good and performs well on any kind of volume. So it's not only good for one kind of music at one kind of volume, but it really sounds good with any kind of track you throw at it, thanks to the quite, linear frequency response with a slight emphasis on bass, but still that's just fine. So it sounds good with any kind of music you throw at it, and it will also perform good on any kind of volume. So on low volumes you get this nice kind of dynamic bass boost and treble boost, so it simply sounds a bit more sparkly and kicking on low volumes and not as tinny as the Go Play or the FIFA, for example. On normal volumes I think it got very impressive. As you could hear, the HomePod could stack up nicely against the other speakers. And again, keep in mind, today we compared the HomePod against the best of the best you could find this class. So anything else you compare the HomePod to is worse than the FIFA Helsinki or the Go Play. So we really took the best examples for speakers in this price class and compared them to the Apple HomePod. And as you could hear, the HomePod could stack up nicely. In some cases, I even preferred it over the others. But overall, I think that I have done my job. I found out that it definitely is a really, mature speaker in this class, and that it can definitely keep up with the top-notch speakers at this price point. The only thing I would maybe criticize sound-wise is that there, of course, could be even more loudness, even more treble and everything, but this is not it. I would criticize maybe that the bass sometimes is a little bit too uncontrolled. It seems like it doesn't have enough force to control the driver sometimes. The S3, for example, sometimes sounds a bit more, dense and tight than the HomePod, but this is just a very small issue, or not even a real issue. Sometimes with really heavy recordings you will notice it, but that's really not a big deal at all. It still sounds really nice. So as an overall sound verdict from a real audiophile, I hope that I'm quite trustworthy. You could of course also hear this from the recordings. If you don't agree with me, again, keep in mind it's all subjective. Maybe you don't like the HomePod at all, but just from a really objective perspective, which you could also hear in the video with the recordings, I can tell you that even at the steep price tag of $350, I can simply recommend this thing, as it definitely belongs to one of the best speakers in this class. Of course, still, the FIFA Helsinki sounded quite a bit clearer with more treble sparkle and clearer mids, but of course it didn't have the same bass power, especially in high volumes, as the HomePod. And of course the Go Play still offers a little bit more bass, especially when you crank them higher, maybe for a party or something. The Go Play will simply, gain momentum, as it simply is the bigger speaker with bigger drivers. But overall I can say, I did my job here. I found out that the HomePod definitely belongs to the best speakers in this class. It can definitely be up there with the top-notch speakers, the Harman Kardon Go Play and the FIFA Helsinki, as well as the S3, and it doesn't fully lose against them. It is definitely on one level when it comes to sound quality with them, and I was really impressed, as I expected much less from it, but apparently it's in one league with those really good sounding speakers. Still, keep in mind, maybe some of you prefer the FIFA by quite a bit, so the others still had advantages, but of course on the other hand, the HomePod also had advantages with certain tracks. So it's really about you. Speaker testing is a very subjective thing, but from an objective audiophile perspective, I can give this thing a thumbs up and tell you that it's definitely up there with the really good speakers. Talking about Siri now, of course Siri is lagging behind, but for this kind of stuff you can check out any other video, as most people did a comparison between Amazon Echo, Google Home and Siri, and you can just notice that Siri is lagging behind. I hope that there will be a software update soon where Siri gets some new functions, at least some basic stuff like telling a joke. I mean, she cannot even do this, which is quite sad, but again, I'm hoping for a software update. Still, she can do the basic stuff, like, you know, controlling music, especially when you are tied into the Apple ecosystem with the iPhone and Apple Music. You can do some basic stuff with her, but I hope that it will get better soon. The only thing I really liked about Siri compared to the others is that the HomePod or Siri recognizes your voice from really everywhere. No matter how loud you turn the speaker, you don't need to shout in order to make it recognize you, while with an Amazon Echo, which is even softer than the HomePod, you really need to scream and shout at it in order to, you know, make it turn on, which is of course a big advantage of the HomePod. So as a full verdict, I can say this thing definitely is a really good speaker. Also for its price tag, it's definitely up there with other speakers. Again, which one you like more and which one you like most and which one is your package, yeah, of course, comes down to your personal preferences. Everything is a subjective thing, but from an objective side, it's really up there with others. And of course, Siri is just like, how to say this, little extra on top. It's not really, up there with Amazon Echo when it comes to the smart capabilities. I would rather say it's a primary good sounding speaker, which is comparable to the other good sounding speakers in this class, and secondary, a smart speaker, as the smart functions are not really that smart in this case. So if you are fully tied into the Apple ecosystem and you have an iPhone and Apple Music and you primarily want a really good sounding speaker which can really keep up with the other really good models, and your secondary factor is on smart features like Siri, then the HomePod will definitely be the one for you. It integrates nicely with the Apple world. You know, you can still do basic things with Siri, so it's not like she can do nothing, but of course it's lagging behind compared to the others. Still, I think it's a really good sounding speaker, and if this is the right package for you, again, this is subjective, it is definitely a nice package even for the price tag. So for me personally, the HomePod definitely is a good package as it really, you know, matches me. Sound wise, subjective or objective, it's simply a good sounding speaker, so that's great already. The smart functions are more than enough for me. I don't need to control my entire home and my entire life with a smart speaker. So this kind of Siri is enough for me. Just saying volume up, volume down or next track. This is more than enough for my personal requests. And of course, I am fully tied into the Apple ecosystem already. I have an iPhone, I have Apple Music. So basically, it's a really matching speaker for my personal, circumstances. But now, let's end the video. So if you enjoyed it, please leave a like or subscribe to the channel to see many more comparisons of the HomePod coming up soon. Until then, have a great time and bye-bye.